Did I film one of these 3 months ago? Yes. Did I buy and read enough books to need to film one of these again? Also, yes. With that being said, we have a very quick IKEA, among other things, haul. That is mainly I bought another shelf because I have the Billy bookcase. And right now I have one extra shelf in, but that means all the shelves are kind of uneven heights. So this will even everything out too. Oh my God, it's darkening so much. I also got a plant, a real life plant. I am not good at keeping plants alive, but I'm gonna try really, really hard. This is an English ivy and I'm gonna repot it into this little pot that I got from Walmart. And we're gonna put it on top of my bookshelf and just hope that it grows down the bookshelf because I think it'd be really pretty. I also got a Cadbury cream egg. You didn't need to know that, but it's Easter. So first up, we're going to go out and pot my plants, and then we're gonna take all the books off my bookshelf so we can add in the extra shelf, and then I have to figure out how I want to organize everything. And at the end, we're gonna do a TBR cart tour. This is kind of just a bunch of bookish things in one day, in one video. I hope you enjoy. It's literally dirt. It's literally dirt. You don't want it. My plant is potted, so I think it's gonna go on top of the shelf for now. Next step, we have to take everything off the bookshelf, so wish me luck. I don't know why the lights look like they're going crazy. I'm just gonna turn those off. That's so distracting. Everything on the shelf because the shelf can't move. Like, this is the middle one. I don't plan on changing it, so the shelf is gonna stay full. On the shelf, I have these like little flower lights, and I just realized I taped them to the shelf, so I'm gonna have to undo that. So this is the current damage that we need to deal with. If you recall, I also have a shelf over here, which is basically all my childhood books, and we're not really gonna worry about her. I'm happy with how that one is. And then over here is my TBR cart, which is pretty full. So I think we're gonna do a little book unhaul to try and deal with all this chaos. I'm gonna pile to unhaul here. So some of these I've had for a while and I just haven't gotten around to donating them, but the first book I'm gonna get rid of is Carnival. I DNF'd this series and I just don't think I'm ever gonna go back to it, and I only have the first book because once I read the first book and I didn't really like it, I got the rest from the library. This is just taking up space on my shelf. Next, I'm gonna get rid of Icebreaker. I did not enjoy this book. It's not really for me. I think I might read Wildfire because the setting intrigues me. It takes place at a summer camp and I think that could be fun. I'm definitely not gonna buy it in physical copy. So that is going. I'm also gonna get rid of None of This is True by Lisa Jewell. I was very underwhelmed by this. From now on, I'm gonna try and only buy thrillers from authors that I know I like, because I'm already kind of picky about thrillers and it's not necessarily a genre I feel the need to have on my shelf. Getting rid of The Darkest Minds. I think I might have shown this in like literally a year ago, a book on haul, because I just haven't gotten around to taking this to BMV where they like buy your used books. I'm also gonna get rid of His and Hers by Alice Feeney. I'm not gonna read this. I've had it on my TBR for so long. The description on the back doesn't tell me anything about this, so I'm just like, I'm not interested or intrigued by it at all. I am getting rid of Three Holidays and a Wedding. I did not love this. It's like a Christmassy romance. I just found it kind of boring, so hopefully we'll go to someone else that does like it. I'm getting rid of The Tales of Beedle and Bard from Harry Potter. I just don't feel like I need this. I'm getting rid of my UK copy of The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes. If you watch my book haul, I bought the one that matched my Hunger Games set. And then I'm also getting rid of Harry Potter and the Cursed Child. I don't think I even ever read this. I have no interest in reading this, so it's going. Now, I'm going to put in the new shelf. The problem I have with adding an extra shelf, and you will see in a minute, they're very short. It makes them very short, where it only fits either a paperback or a shorter hardcover. bookshelf has all the new shelves added now, and it's even, which is nice, because before these shelves were huge and then the top shelves were tiny. Now there's an even number of shelves on the top and the bottom. I'm gonna start trying to put all my books back. I had an all-time soul. Baby, we were kissing for the whole ride home. Laying, making wishes, it was all night long. You told me you loved me and I sang this song. I sang this song. Hey, buddy. Don't eat that. Checking a little bit. Here's what I was saying earlier. On this shelf, it's too short for even like a normal size paperback to stand up, so only like weirdly short paperbacks fit. So like you can see in the corner here, I have Trial of the Sun Queen in the sequel because they're like weirdly short and they can stand up, but like all of those paperbacks down there, they're too tall. That's kind of like the YA shelf, I think, is the vibe. And then this is going to be fantasy also, because this is pretty much all YA fantasy, plus the Inheritance Games, and then this is YA fantasy over there, but then this is adult fantasy. So I think it has to be YA, YA transitioning into adult, and then this shelf, we get to adult fantasy, if that makes sense. I feel like the problem I was running into though previously is that I was kind of running out of room for romance books, which were on this shelf down here, and that's where I'm gonna put them again. But I realized I didn't really give myself extra room for romance. Maybe we can see if some of them will fit on this shelf. So all we have left really is thrillers and literary fiction, which I am gonna put down here. You can't even see half the shelf because of the chair. So since this is the genres I have the least of, I figure it just makes the most sense for them to go down there. Like I used to, baby. Look in my eyes and deny that you ever felt love this. I think we're finished for now at least. I'm gonna do like a quick overview so you can see every shelf, and then we're going to move over to my TBR card. Welcome to my new TBR cart. It's not new. New and improved. Updated. I ended up putting the plant here because I wanted it to thrive. And I feel like this is the best spot for it to be because my window's right up here. So then it's getting like a lot of indirect light versus the kind of dark corner that it would be in if it was on top of the bookshelf. And then next to it, I just have this month's TBR. I originally used to have only this top shelf and then the middle shelf as my TBR. And then the bottom shelf was just kind of empty. I don't know why. But so now I'm using the bottom shelf. So this shelf is just the books I want to read this month in my Kindle. Then down here we have... I can't get this one out. We'll start down here. In a Holidays by Christina Lauren. One Last Stop by Casey McQuiston. Check In Mate by Allie Hazelwood. Love and Other Words by Christina Lauren. I need to read this. Somebody make me read this. A Touch of Darkness by Scarlett St. Clair. The Prison Healer by Lynette Noni. Scythe by Neil Shusterman. The Dead Romantics by Ashley Poston. Funny You Should Ask by Alyssa Sussman. We Are Not Like Them by Christine Pride and Joe Piazza. Betting on You by Lynn Painter. Circe by Madeline Miller. And In My Dreams, I Hold a Knife by Ashley Winstead. And then on the bottom shelf here that you cannot see, we have Stone Blind by Natalie Haynes, Starcrossed by Minnie Dark, How to Kill Men and Get Away with It by Katie Brent, Wrong Place, Wrong Time by Gillian McAllister, Fairy Tale by Stephen King, House of Salt and Sorrow by Aaron A. Craig, and then Dance of Thieves and also Vow of Thieves by Mary E. Pearson. And those are all the books that I currently have on my physical TBR. I'll do a quick overview
of the TBR cart so you can see what it looks like. I'll overlay it here. But other than that, now I have space for more books, which is the most important part. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, subscribe down below. It would mean so much to me, and I will hopefully see you in my next video. Bye!